So last week I finally got to watch Captain Marvel. It's a great movie, nothing too spectacular, but I love the way it builds up the backstory of the Avengers. And now with Avengers Endgame coming up in a few weeks, I just can't help but talk about one of the biggest fan theories around the sequel, which is to travel back in time and reverse Thanos' snap in the Infinity War. I know a lot of videos out there are already talking about the time travel theory, but today we're doing something different. Today we aren't going to break down any trailers, reveal any plots, or discover any Easter eggs. Today, we're going to simply talk about science and the real possibility of the Avengers actually traveling back in time. And you definitely want to stay till the end because I'm going to tell you about my scientific conclusion. As you may already know, space-time is a four-dimensional continuum in modern physics. On top of the three-dimensional space we live in, time is the fourth dimension. Now, in our physical world, we can move front and back, left and right, up and down. But can we do the same with time? Well, Einstein's theories actually do not prevent time travel from happening. As he described, time is like a river. It bends around stars, speeds up, and slows down. This river of time can even fork into two rivers, or even create whirlpools where time can go in on itself. Although Einstein's equations do allow for time travel, you may wonder about all the logical paradoxes, like the grandfather paradox, which argues how can you be born in the first place if you can go back in time to kill your own grandfather? Well, there are actually two ways around these paradoxes. One is the self-consistency principle, which states that anything that can change the past cannot happen. This means even if the Avengers manage to go back in time, something will prevent them from altering the course of history. No matter what they do, nothing will prevent Thanos from gathering all the Infinity Stones. Just as Doctor Strange said,
"There was no other way."
Well, personally, I don't really buy this explanation. I think it's just a cheesy way of dodging the question. This is why we have a second solution to these paradoxes, which is the many-world interpretation of quantum mechanics, simply known as the existence of parallel universes. In this way, when the Avengers travel back in time, they aren't actually going back in their own timeline. Instead, they're entering a parallel universe, fighting an other Thanos, saving an other world. But all these will not change the fact that half of their own universe was already wiped out and can never be undone. So far, both theories do allow for time travel given that we do not change our own past. But here comes my third solution, which may give us a whole new perspective to any time paradox. A solution so bizarre that it is not explored very often, even in science fictions. This is a theory proposed by British physicist David Doge, who suggests that instead of forking into two timelines, time may go on and on and on in a closed loop, just like in Doctor Strange.
Dormammu, I've come to bargain.
And not just any closed loop, the universe actually becomes a Mobius strip with two timelines existing at the same time. Consider the grandfather paradox, but this time with Tony Stark going back in time to kill his own grandfather. The classical paradox is if Tony killed his grandfather, he wouldn't be born, so he couldn't go back in time to kill his grandfather in the first place. Well, if we extend beyond this paradoxical conclusion, the story could be different. Tony goes back in time, kills his grandfather, so he isn't born, thus he cannot go back in time, so his grandfather isn't killed, so he is born, thus he can go back in time and kill his grandfather, and so on. This looks like a linear series of events, but really it is two entangled histories happening at the same time. In other words, if Tony really goes back in time to kill his own grandfather, he will become both dead and alive at the same time, like the Schrodinger's cat in a famous thought experiment. In the case of the Avengers, if the survivors manage to go back and stop Thanos, everyone who got snapped away in the Infinity War will become both human and dust at the same time. This may be very hard to imagine since quantum mechanics is rarely applied to large objects, but for subatomic particles, it is actually very common for them to exist in several different states at the same time. This is called quantum superposition and are responsible for many properties of atoms and molecules, including nuclear fusion and the sun's core. Right now, we have theories that support time travel without any paradox, so does that mean the Avengers are good to go? Not necessarily, because even though there is no laws of physics that prevent time travel, the energy required to do so is gigantic. Michio Kaku, a famous theoretical physicist, once said that not even an atomic bomb has enough energy. To drive a time machine, it requires the energy of an exploding star. Where can the Avengers get the energy from? Maybe, just maybe, Captain Marvel.
I like this one.